Amen. Now, look very careful for the word of God. God does not mind that we have good things in life. Are you me, church? I want to be clear with that. Baka sabihin nyo, ah, si pastor na mahipit, ayaw niya. Ako rin, especially marami, back in Cavite, paraging stateside yung mga gamit ko, hang 10, OP, hash puppies, you know, ma-forma din ako eh. That's what I'm saying. Now, but life does not consist of those things alone. He says it, it will be whoever store up things for themselves. Amen? People are just looking for themselves. Me, me, me. That's the story of Luke chapter 12. It's just concentrated on themselves. The last part. But is not rich towards God. Can we be rich toward ourselves and be rich towards God? Hello? Amen? So, God was saying to us, and I believe it's saying to all of us today, let's not just concentrate for ourselves. Because there are other big things that we need to understand. There are other big things that we need to understand. Yeah. Our life is not just here. Yeah. Amen. There are other things that we need to understand. Yeah. Our life in eternity. Are you with me, church? Yeah. Amen. That's why. And then Jesus mentioned about do not worry in Luke chapter 12. Do not worry what you will eat, what you will wear. For life does not consist of this thing. And then later on, he said to his disciple, this is his disciple, this is not the rich young man, no, it's different. He said to his disciple, sell your possession and give it to those in need. This will store up treasure for you in heaven. And the purses of heaven never get old or develop holes. Your treasure will be saved. Hallelujah. No thief can steal it and no man can destroy it. Wherever your treasure is, there the desire of your heart will also be. In other words, when you invest to the life of someone, you are investing in the back of heaven. In the treasury of heaven. Diba? You are investing in the treasury of heaven. Are you in the church? When you are giving, the kingdom of God is about giving. Amen. The kingdom of God, it's about giving. Amen. But listen to me. The kingdom of God, it's about giving. That's why God also gives.
Amen.
Diba? Amen. The kingdom of God, it's about giving. When you look at your Bible, you will see Jesus always saying, give to the poor, give to the poor, give to the needy, give to the orphan. You will see His word full of that, always about giving. Now, because that's the kingdom of God, Max Lucado said, in giving, we are closely look like God because God is a giver. Are you with me, church? Amen. Now, you remember in Christmas time or in birthday time, you are looking for the best. You are looking for the best for your wife, for your husband, for your children, to give them their best for their gift for this special day. You are looking to give your best to this person, to your loved ones. Church, listen, how much more your Father in heaven will give you the best. Amen. In fact, He give you His very best, His Son.
Amen.
Amen. Are you with me, church? So, the Word of God says, let's give to His Word and to the people. When you do that, you are storing up treasure for you in heaven. Where the purses of heaven never get old or never have holes. In other words, hindi nawawala yung investment mo eh. Sa kingdom of God, the kingdom of God, the purses of heaven never have holes. Amen. Have you experienced this? That you thought you have enough and then your purses just like have holes because you just handle it, the money, and then it just go away. Have you experienced that? No, but it's like water. You hold it for a day or two, and then the money just go away. Now because you have to pay this interest, you have to pay this, you have to pay that, you have to pay that. Why? Because you are just investing in yourselves. You are just investing on earthly things. Begin to look and invest in the kingdom of God. And you will see your parts will not have, will not develop holes. Are you in the church? You will see the kingdom of God provided you everything that you need. Hallelujah. So, as we have studied Luke chapter 6, no, and finished that the text, no, sabi doon sa verse, ano, it's a matter of what? Let's continue, no? Ito yung text natin. Wherever your treasure is, there the desires of your heart will also be. Your eyes is a lamp that provides light for your body. When your eye is good, your whole body is filled with light. But when your eye is bad, your whole body is filled with darkness. And if the light you think you have is actually darkness, how deep that darkness is. No one can serve two masters, for you will hate one and love the other. You will be devoted to one and despise the other. You cannot serve both God and money. It's a matter of three things. Now, in closing in our study of Matthew chapter 6, three things. It's a matter of heart, of perspective, and of lordship. Amen? It says, the desires of your heart will also be. So, your treasure, there is where your heart, not the other way around. The treasure will not follow your heart. No, your heart will follow what you treasure. Hello? Amen? Maliwanag po ba? It's not the other way around. Your treasure will follow your heart. No, what your heart treasure, you will follow. Did you get it? Give you an example. Diba? For example, when I was in I think grade school, grade 6, when my Kuya Georgie teach me how to learn chess. No, and it was cool. First year, I was beating my classmate. So, wow, this is good, this is nice. I was beating the top of the class because my Kuya is very good in chess. He has book and luck. So he teach me. So when I went to first year high school, no, because this is the end of grade 6, I beat those, you know, and because of that, people are accepting me, that my new group, my newfound friends in high school is accepting me because I'm very good, no? So I'm beating them, and you know, and I'm learning. And then after a few months, I spend times, I read books, I really study and spend countless of times studying and learning, playing chess. You know, and I become a good, no, not so very, very good, but I become good, able to meet, you know, average person in chess. You know? But there are these people, no, and after a while, I change my heart's desire, my treasure. It becomes billiard. You know? It becomes billiard. So I pursue billiard because that's my treasure, my newfound treasure. That's my heart desire. I even leave classes or will not attend classes to pursue my treasure, playing billiard. Are you in church? Diba? So I'm good at chess now and I'm also good in billiard. Diba? And then, I think it was in college that I pursued ping pong. So three things now are consuming my time, my energy, my life. Now I'm after of these things, playing chess, playing billiard, and playing ping pong. These are now become my treasure. It becomes now my idol. Then I become born again. I learn God. One by one, I surrender this because I find the true treasure. Jesus Christ. I gave up reading the books of chess and began to read the Bible. I gave up, you know, the playing billiard to be excellent in billiard so I can attend Bible study and prayer meeting. I give up my ping pong so I can attend Bible study. Why? Because I find my new treasure.